BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Good evening, my name is Karen Haver and welcome to Berks Arts on BCTV. We're thrilled to have a nice fall evening here, and I want to welcome my guests Robin Zaremski from KU Presents.
Thank you for having
us. And Sue Biebuyck with The Art of Film. The official season is kicking off now, and so it's great to see all of the arts events kicking up throughout Berks County. And we're excited to hear about different events and exhibits that are going on. And we want to make sure that you sign up for Berks Arts Council's e-blast for weekly updates on what's going on throughout the community and calls to artists and things like that. So please make sure you check us out on berksarts.org and sign up for our email list. Also, a couple other Berks Arts Council things before I get into my guests is reminding you that although fall just began, Peter White Christmas, our favorite holiday tradition, tickets are on sale now, and you can find out more information by visiting Miller Center. It's the Miller Center at RAC, so www.rac.edu/MillerCenter, or you can find out everything by visiting berksjazzfest.com or call us at the office. So, jumping right in, I'm going to talk to this is Robin Zaremski from KU Presents. So Robin, thanks so much for coming on.
Thank you for having us to talk a little bit about our season.
You've had a really exciting season. You have a really exciting season planned, but it's already started. So we'll give some quick love to Berks Jazz Fest favorite, Trombone Shorty.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I understand that show sold out.
The show was sold out, and it was absolutely fantastic. He was energized. He was exciting. He did, again, a lot of new brass songs, and then he did some old New Orleans jazz brass. We had people dancing in the aisles. It was a lot of fun, a great way to kick off our season this year.
He really is. That his energy is so contagious.
It is.
And
it is very much
so much fun. So it's a great way to really cross generation too, catching the your students as well as your town and gown. So I hope everybody had as much fun as I do when I see Trombone Shorty. So.
We had a little bit of a New Orleans lawn party beforehand. Weather was perfect, and our KU boogie band opened up with a little bit of brass for that evening, as well as we had our KU sketch club doing some sketches of people there at the night. So it was just a lot of fun.
So you've got a lot of student activities that are tied into, which
absolutely
is neat. So hopefully we'll have a chance to talk about those as we go through each mm-hmm. of your events. Now, your October show is a lot of fun, and this is such a great year for it. The campaigns have been kicking off, and mm-hmm. you've got Capitol Steps. And anybody who's ever seen Capitol Steps, it's very political and very funny. So tell us a little bit about the event and when it is and how to get tickets, of course.
If you aren't getting enough amusement with all of the debates that are going on, the political debates now, you can go to Capitol Steps, which is a group of staffers, used to be Capitol staffers, that make fun of the nation's capital, makes fun of political satire, parodies. They are terrific singers, terrific comedians, and they just interweave contemporary songs, but done in parody style of what's happening in politics today. And I love the show. I think it's one of the funniest shows I've ever seen, and it is very relevant now. So if you want to have a little bit of election levity and have a little bit of fun with what's going on in politics today, Capitol Steps is a great show.
And all of these performers who are campaigning are a lot more interesting than the real candidates. they do a great job of really picking the highlights and then the caricatures of them, shall we say. Now, you're tying this in with not only with the Capitol Steps performance, but you've got something going along. You've got a little tag-on event, too.
We do. We have what we're calling a mock campaign dinner, and we are going to have campaign buttons. Of course, support KU is going to be our motto. We'll have people be able to make speeches if they want at the campaign dinner. We're going to have political slogans that people can hold up and take pictures with. And I have to say, at this point, this dinner is actually sold out at this
fantastic.
Time.
Oh, fantastic. Okay.
So, but it is something that's going to start the night off with, again, a lot of fun and a lot of levity, and actually a great meal, too. An all-American meal with apple pie. So,
as long as there's apple pie, I'm in. So, and I'm going to try and, we have a little bit of the video for that, but I'm going to come back to that. I want to come back to that after we go through the rest of the season,
great.
And hopefully we have enough time.
Great. Event that we have coming up is actually part of our sesquicentennial celebration, which is our 150th anniversary at Kutztown University. It is called Celebrate Marimba, and we are going to have over 150 marimbists playing on marimbas and different instruments to celebrate our 150th anniversary.
And I think we had a little mention of this, Dr. Willis Rapp, who
yes.
is conductor of the Reading Pops mm-hmm. Orchestra. So he and I talked about this a little bit over the summer. He was very excited about it. So he's got this great connection too. And you have the Percussive Arts Society. You've got some Hall of Fame inductees. So
we're going to be actually... they're going to be creating a piece specifically for this event, this 150th anniversary. And as you had mentioned, Dr. Rapp is one of the conductors. And also, we have KU faculty that will be conducting as well and doing pieces with, yes, we do plan on fitting everybody into the Schaefer Auditorium and the stage.
I was
going to
ask.
All of the marimbas.
So, but it's 150
marimbists, but
75 okay.
pieces
so
of instrumentation. Right, right.
And will there be anything heard besides the marimba?
There will not be. There will
so
not
it's
be.
100%
it will be strictly
all marimba all the time.
Time. There also, it's going to be a weekend of events with the music department. They're going to be having some vendors there to, if you are interested in purchasing a marimba or mallets or giving some instruction on that. So it's an entire weekend event culminating with the performance on that Sunday, November 8th. And it should be a lot of fun. We have people coming from all different states, from all over the eastern coast, and some coming from even farther than that. So.
It sounds wonderful, and you know everybody needs a marimba festival. So
I have to tell you, when I first heard this, I thought, it should be interesting. But we've had people come out of the woodwork. The minute they hear we're doing this, we'll hear stories about people saying, oh, my mother played marimba 30 years ago. Is she going to be able to participate in this? So it is just going to be all ages, just from all across the country. It should be a lot of fun. We're excited about it.
Yeah, and I think if you want to learn more about the marimba, it's obviously a great place. I mean, it's such an amazing instrument. It's so beautiful. And, you know, doesn't quite fit in the back of your car unless you've got a big car. But, you know, as far as instruments to take up, I think that the marimba is one of the more fascinating ones.
It's very unique. Now, I've had people say to me, what is a marimba? And people probably know the most common name. It looks like a xylophone, but it should be... a lot of fun. And of course, KU has an archive of antique marimbas that we're going to be bringing out for this particular event, so it should be a lot of fun.
They do have the poster behind us, so you can see the marimba in the corner if you were not quite sure. And then you go into the holiday season.
Yes.
And this is kind of neat because you've got this tie-in with Earth and Sky.
Yes, we love it. We love it. The gentleman's name is William Close, and he plays an instrument called the Earth Harp. He's with the Earth Harp Collective.
What is an Earth Harp?
And this is great if you have never seen it. Now, he has been on America's Got Talent. A lot of people are very familiar with him because
he
came down to...
He's the top image on that poster.
Exactly. So. He came down to one of the finalists, and Howard Stern just spoke the world of him, thought he was great. But what it is there is a base of the instrument that is on the stage. We are going to string the strings all the way up to our lighting booth, which is to the ceiling of Schaefer Auditorium. And the concert is a holiday concert, so there will be holiday tunes, such as Little Drummer Boy and No More War. And he will play the Earth Harp, where the strings are over the audience's head. And he has other instrumentation on. He'll have drums and violinists and vocalists. And it will be quite an event. We're spending a few days even before the event stringing up the Earth Harp.
Excuse me.
So we're excited.
But then you've got Because you're doing these great tie-ins.
Yes, we love it.
So this is a neat tie-in.
We always want it to be an entire experience when people come to Schaefer Auditorium. It's not just the show, which is obviously going to be a great reason to come to Schaefer, but we also add additional events to make it a full experience. And on that particular night, the folks who are coming to see William Close and the Earth Harp also have the opportunity to go to the KU Planetarium and see a holiday show in our planetarium with laser lights. And there's a show before William Close at 6:30, and then there's one at 9:45. So we're making an entire night of it. It's a Friday night. We hope people bring their family, their young children. And we know that once they leave that evening, they're going to be talking about this show for many months to come.
Yeah, it sounds neat, and it sounds like such a great treat to bring, to bring all ages together.
Something very, very different.
So, and then you go into
our spring,
your spring session,
right? Our spring. Our first show is it's Vocalocity, which a lot of people this year enjoyed Pitch Perfect 2, and I know I was a fan of Pitch Perfect 1. And there's a gentleman named Deke Sharon who does all of the musical arrangements for those two movies. He has created his own show called Vocalocity, which we're going to be presenting on February 17th, 2016. And basically the show is a very fresh take on traditional pop songs, new songs, and just showing all of the possibilities of the voice.
This is done without any other instruments.
Correct.
It's entirely
correct.
A cappella. So yes. I think that's, and it's really amazing to see. I mean, if anybody's ever seen Bobby McFerrin and some of the things that he does vocally.
Unbelievable.
And when you get a group of people together, there are so many wonderful, there's another one that's been floating around the YouTube lately, but check out Vocalocity.
One thing that they do that I think is amazing, and again, you can see this if you go to our website, is that they go through Beatles songs from a historical perspective on a cappella, and they start from Gregorian chant, then they go to choral music, then they'll do barbershop quartet, and then they move to contemporary a cappella, and all through using the Beatles songs.
Okay.
So it is an amazing show. It is something he handpicked all of the songs and all of the arrangements for. And we're going to another event that we're going to have along with this is we're going to have an a cappella competition before the Vocalocity show so that different groups, different college organizations, high school groups can actually submit their work. And Deke Sharon is actually going to choose one of those works for a group to actually open up the second half of the Vocalocity show.
Oh, how wonderful.
So we're going to
great
be starting that in November. And hopefully, again, we're looking forward to it. It's brand new, never been done before, and we're really excited that they chose Kutztown University to have one of their performances.
Oh, that's great. And then March, you go into, with March, you've got the whole Celtic thing happening.
Absolutely.
Everybody does, but this is a little bit different than just strictly Celtic because you've got Natalie McMaster and Danelle Lay.
Mm-hmm.
And
husband and wife.
And well, tell us about them because I love Natalie.
They come from Cape Breton, in Canada, and it is a little bit of a different Celtic sound, but they infuse Celtic and Scottish fiddle, as well as Americana and bluegrass fiddle. And Natalie and her husband are two of the most top-notch fiddlers in the world, and we're lucky that we're having them again around that particular time of year.
She is amazing.
She is amazing, and they bring their family. They have numerous children, and even they participate in the show, and they have so much energy and so much stamina. We just had to bring them because we know how much, particularly the Berks County area with the Lions Fiddle Fest, how much fiddling in this area has just become very popular.
And then you're having a traditional dinner to go with this.
This is very interesting.
Traditional Cape Breton.
Yes. She actually is a terrific cook. No one knows that. It's a secret. But we found out on her website she actually has her favorite recipes. So along with the show, the Natalie McMaster show, we are having Cape Breton Celtic dinner. And we're going to be having some of her favorite recipes, her family's favorite recipes. So another very, very unique night.
Okay. And then you're going to finish out the season with Ramin
Karimloop, my favorite performer in the entire world. And that is saying a lot. I've seen a lot of people. He just came off of Broadway. He was Jean Valjean on Broadway, and he also played the Phantom in the 25th anniversary of Phantom of the Opera, as well as currently is starting a new show called The Prince of Broadway, which is debuting in Japan. But Ramin is the most amazing vocalist, and he not only does Broadway well, but he does this thing called Broadgrass, which mixes Broadway and bluegrass, and he has a great song that he does, Oh What a Beautiful Morning from Oklahoma, mm-hmm. but he does it in kind of the Avett Brothers style.
Oh, how fun.
So, but vocally he is so talented, and he is such a nice guy. And we are really excited to close our season with him. And in particular, he's going to be helping us celebrate our new president's inauguration.
Oh, neat.
At the end of April.
And I think the best way to get information, thank you, Robin, mm-hmm. we've got a great introduction to all these artists, but which days, when is it happening? Visit kutztownpresents.org.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. And you can get all of the information, or you can just do an online search for Kutztown Presents. Robin and Amy will be happy to help you out.
Yes,
and,
thank you. We will.
Really take care of you. And it's such a great place to see a show, too. So now, hopefully we'll have time at the end to see a little mm-hmm. bit of Capital Steps, but I know in the last show, Sue Biebuyck has not left the studio, but in the last show, you gave an introduction to the art of film, and I think this is a really exciting aspect of the Film Festival, and we're all very excited to have the Film Festival come back to Reading. So the art of film, and where did they get such a great idea?
Exactly. So, attributed to the Berks Arts Council's beautiful Jazz Fest art exhibit, which we have every year, excuse my voice, is inspired this whole thing. And they thought, well, if they can do it for the Jazz Fest, why can't they do it for this Film Fest? And somehow I got involved. And so we've turned it into this really fun exhibit, which, I mean, film is a part of our culture. So I thought it would be really fun, and it has turned out to be really interesting, and I'm so proud of the work that has been churned out by our artists, and I've lost my voice over it, so it's really wonderful.
Do you know, about how many pieces did you get in?
Gosh, I didn't check, but I probably have like 50.
Okay,
not
so
a lot, great, but yeah, some people only put one in, but yeah.
It's a great, and
people put their heart into it, though. I have to say that the quantity isn't real high, but the quality is really up there.
And then that's at the Lois Long Gallery at GAPS, yep. which is 48 North 5th Street. 148 North 5th Street, thank you. Gotta thank Laura Cooper.
Yes.
And they do such a great job at that gallery,
yeah.
too. So,
also, you if you come, because it's going to be, the opening's actually Thursday night, October 15th, and it's 5 to 8, so you can park on the street or
yes.
at
the Abe Lincoln also.
The Abe parking. Lincoln, which is fabulous parking. I was there all day. And no problems whatsoever.
Yeah. And I think that's what we wanted to talk about a little bit is the opening. You have so it's Thursday, October 15th, 5 to 8 p.m. It doesn't cost anything to come to the opening.
No.
And all of the winners will be announced then.
So 6:30, we're going to announce winners. Tomorrow, the jury is going to take place. Our jurors are Bob Metzger, and everyone knows him as a true authoritarian on art in the United yes. States and around the world. He writes a lot of books about art and catalogs for every museum. He is still at, I don't know what his young age is, but he is still writing books about artists. So
formerly the director of the Reading Public Museum.
Yeah, and actually very...
stayed here in Reading.
Exactly. Wonderful to have his acquaintance and be a friend of his.
And he's got an amazing film connection, too.
He does, and he was involved with the film festival to begin with.
Yes.
Back in the beginning of its...
Yeah, in its infancy.
Yes.
So
he was delighted when I asked him to jury. We also have Laura Lynn White, who is the director at the Goggle Works, who connected me with Tracy Schott, who I turned out to kind of know already through some other people. But anyway, needless to say, it's a community project, and we're all excited that it's really happening. And I only heard about it 3 months ago, and wow, it's already happening.
It's really exciting. So What type of medium do you have, or submitted? What type of picture can people expect to see? Because we don't have any preview pictures. Because
I know.
This is the first time it's ever happened, so we can't even show what it looked like
painting.
Last year. So
We have some unusual entries. We have a three-dimensional entry that is, I'll just say some movies, which is like Alfred Hitchcock, The Birds. And I'll just tell you, that's the inspiration.
So you've got inspirations. Maybe that's the best thing, is maybe tell us, share some of the inspirations that...
We have Silence of the Lambs. There's a Jimi Hendrix movie, came into the Hard Day's Night is big. I was surprised at a lot of musical movies, but there's some pieces that are just film references.
Well, and it's like music in the, you know, with the art of jazz. Some of them, there's not a direct... You can't give a direct. It's the inspiration of film
right.
and that idea. So
right, but it's been like really fun watching it come in. Star Wars was big.
And so your opening is Thursday, October 15th, 5 to 8, and
yep.
we got to make sure to give love to Judy's on Cherry because Judy is catering the event.
Yeah, and you know I love her anyway. So.
So, and I think that...
Hardest working woman in Reading, right?
Yeah, and...
Yeah, besides you.
she has wonderful food, so
yeah.
So that's always good, and so you can have great food and great art. And then Starving Artist Winery is based out of Lewis Long, and
right.
So Peter, correct?
Yes, Peter.
And Peter, so that's Peter's wine, and so they'll have tastings throughout the night too, I'm
yeah.
sure.
Mm-hmm. Yep, it's really been interesting working with them and being in that space. It's a really great space.
Okay, and again, for more information on that, you can visit readingfilmfest.com, or you can sign up for the Berks Arts Council's email list at berksarts.org.
I also have other stuff I'm working on. I just want to shoe in
there. Okay.
At Studio B.
We can't forget the love for Studio B.
We still have Till Death Was Hard for another week. And Marilyn Fox.
Marilyn Fox will be opening
October 23rd, and she's through November.
Okay, great.
Yeah. New Paintings, it's called. And I have to tell you, I have never seen so many amazing pieces of work.
Well, that sounds good.
I tip my hat. I aspire. She's amazing.
So, as we promised, we want to try and we're almost done. So, I'm going to actually thank everybody because we're going to try and go into the video. The video will fill out our time here. So, we've got a neat little preview video. So, if you're curious about the Capitol steps and how much fun they are, so if we can have Joan roll the video, and I want to thank you all for tuning in and thank you both for coming on.
Thank you for having
Remember,
us.
Remember, KU present. I'm sorry, KutztownPresents.org. Mm-hmm. Is how to find mm-hmm. more information. And Joan, take it away with Capital Steps.
The Congress had a spiteful fight about the debt increases.
The Senate staff was out of cash to pay their office leases.
Now there's a plan to keep this land from going all to pieces.
Will our economy soon be about as strong as Greece's?
The Super Congress Debt Committee could be quite atrocious.
If they cut programs or raise tax, it could have been ferocious.
I hope John Boehner has a plan and that it is precocious.
Or in a year, who'll reappear? Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
On Thursday, October 22nd, we'll lighten up the long campaign trail with the Capitol Steps, a bold Washington, D.C. comedy troupe that began as a group of Senate staffers who set out to satirize the very people who employed them and the situations their work involved, providing an uproarious blend of musical and political comedy about our nation's capital. The show's tasteful lampooning guarantees to leave both sides of the political spectrum laughing.
We suggest we take a breath, we all should take a long rest. Remember the word progress is the opposite of Congress.
No candidate or topic is safe.
Now I am with the TSA, and we know as you travel you have your choice of invasive security measures. So I'm here tonight to give you a hands-on demonstration. Now, although we do have a full-body scanning machine known as the ISL-ISF, which stands for I See London, I See France, We know many of you prefer the full body pat down, which I highly recommend. Now, during this random procedure, you are randomly chosen to do that. You have been randomly chosen for a full body pat down. I'm sorry, that water is much too dangerous. We can't have that here. Every time I see a pretty girl in line, I just start to hope it. She will choose a pat down rather than the x-ray so I can start her open. Since the TSA said it's okay to be fondled by some slob, we've been flooded with complaints as well as applications for this job.
My mama taught me what to do with guys like you before I was 7. She said try 40 guys who aren't fit to work at 7-Eleven.
Now when you're in line, your body's mine, and the backside can hide a gun.
If you're groped by dope, then you know the terrorists have won.
Their song parodies and skits play off recent headlines and convey their special brand of satirical humor. You haven't heard All About That Bass or Let It Go until you've heard it by the Cap Steps. Honored with a Best of DC award, the Steps have been featured on national TV and radio and have recorded numerous albums, including Fiscal Shades of Grey and their latest Mock the Vote. Come and enjoy a little election levity before the results are in.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.